Good morning everyone. So I'm back today with my third video in this series about computers and laptops. So my first video, I had shown you guys my recommendations or I had given you my recommendations on the components that you can buy for a great gaming PC within a budget of 50,000 rupees. So in today's video, let's stretch our budget by another 50,000 and look at the components that would make up for a really nice gaming PC within a budget of 1 lakh rupees. So since we are spending so much of money, we don't expect just a good gaming PC within this budget. We also expect our computer to do well in all other tasks as well. Say for example, if you're doing video editing, photo editing, other productivity work, right? Say for example, you're doing some office work, running some codes, doing programming, stuff like that. So the recommendations which I'm going to make today for the PC components are not only going to give you a great gaming PC, but also a great productivity PC as well. So let's jump into it. Please note that all these recommendations which I'm showing you are on MD Computer's website. You are free to obviously go ahead and do a check on any other website or any other stores if you are getting a better price. I am showing you all the components on MD Computer's because this is the website where I generally purchase all my PC components from. So the very first thing we'll be covering today is the CPU, which is the brain of our gaming PC. Since this is going to be a gaming PC or gaming focused PC, we don't want like the highest end CPU, right? Our computer is not going to do a lot of processing, CPU based processing. We need a decent enough CPU because we will be doing some amount of other work as well on our PC. So that's why my recommendation is to go for AMD Ryzen 5 3600. You can see on the screen right now. So this is a processor from AMD. This is third gen Ryzen CPU and it's a really capable CPU. This CPU has 6 cores and 12 threads, so it performs really well in multi-core or multi-threaded applications which require multiple threads to run. Say for example, you are a programmer, so you want to maybe execute your codes faster. What you can do is you can make your code run parallelly on all the threads. So in this CPU you are getting 12 threads. The base clock is 3.6 gigahertz and the boost clock is 4.2 gigahertz. This is a really nice CPU. Nothing better can come in this particular price range. So recommend it, add it to the cart. So now moving on to the motherboard of our gaming PC. We could have also gone here with a X570 motherboard, which is the top of the line motherboard for this particular CPU, X570 series of motherboards. But we are going with B550 because we are not going to do a lot of crazy overclocking on our gaming PC. So B550 has been recently released. I think it was released a couple of months back by AMD. So this is an extension of B450 motherboards which used to come earlier. These are more budget oriented motherboards. But this motherboard has everything that we are going to require. This will give you good enough performance. It has got everything that we require. So you can see here it has got triple PCI Express slot. So for example, if I at later point in time, if I want to include a second GPU or a third GPU for that matter in my gaming PC, I can do that with ease. And it obviously comes with the regular tidbits, right? It has 4 DIMM slots, you have VRM cooling, all other stuff. So recommend it, add it to the cart. So now moving on to the RAM. Since we are building a gaming PC, we want decent enough RAM so that our games can run faster, right? RAM is the memory which your computer possesses on which all the applications run. So I would be suggesting to go and get this 16 GB of DDR4 kit. If you are getting RAM from any other brand, which is at least 3000 megahertz and for a cheaper price, please go ahead and do that. This is the cheapest one which I saw on MD Computer, so that's why I'm recommending it. This is 3000 megahertz RAM. DDR4 16 GB. So this would help us to load our games faster whenever we are going to play. Say for example, tomorrow you are going to do a bit of video editing. You launch say some application, right? So this would help you to launch those applications as well quicker. And this is decent enough. At say some point in future, you feel that 16 GB of RAM is not proving enough for your usage or your needs, you can obviously go ahead and purchase another 16 GB RAM of the same brand, same specifications, and then you have 32 GB. So recommended, add it to the cart. So now moving on to the storage, where we will be storing our games, right? So what you can do here, there are two options that you can go with. One option is to actually go and purchase a hard disk drive. So for example, with you can get a 10 TB or a 8 TB hard disk drive. So for now, I'm recommending a 512 GB NVMe SSD. NVMe SSDs are really fast SSDs. They will help you to load anything which is stored on them very quickly, right? So this is 512 GB. This might seem a little low, but since it is NVMe SSD, anything which you store on it will be loaded lightning fast. So for example, if you have a hard disk drive lying around in your home, then kindly use that in combination with this particular SSD. So I would recommend getting an SSD for now, because our aim is to build a really cutting edge high-end gaming PC or a work PC. So this would suffice for that. So this is from ADATA, ADATA XPG. This is 512 GB M.2 NVMe SSD for 7,400 rupees. A really nice SSD for its price. So recommend it, add to the cart. Now, since we are building a gaming PC, everybody would be waiting obviously for the recommendation of graphics card, because that is the one component that would be having the biggest impact on your gaming experience. So it is absolutely necessary that if you are spending 1 lakh rupees on a gaming PC, then you should definitely invest in getting a really nice graphics card. So that's why I am recommending this particular graphics card, which is RTX 2060 from Zotac. So this is a Nvidia graphics card. This is their latest series of graphics card, RTX series. This is a 6 GB graphics card, so decent enough. This graphics card is really capable graphics card if you're doing 1080p gaming, which I think most of us are doing or will be doing. Most of us are not doing 4K gaming or anything of that sort. If you are obviously doing 4K gaming, then you'll have to invest a little more than what I'm showing you right now. This particular graphics card, RTX 2060, is capable of running all the AAA titles at really high frame rates at 1080p. So for 27,000, you can't get anything better than this. So recommend it, add it to the cart. So now coming to our power supply. So we need a good enough power supply for this particular gaming PC, because we have graphics card as well, a powerful CPU and motherboard and other components. So I would recommend getting a modular power supply, because that will help you to cable manage your PC well. It will look better in terms of cable management. And I would also recommend getting at least a gold rated power supply. So this power supply which I'm recommending is from Circle. So Circle is an Indian brand which is known for building PC components like cases, power supplies, fans and stuff like that. So they have this really nice power supply on offer, which is for only 9,600. This is an 850 watt power supply, which would be good enough for all our needs for now, and maybe also give us a good amount of headroom for upgrades in the future. The best thing about this power supply is this. Why I'm choosing this is because this is gold rated. So what does gold rated mean? That the efficiency of this particular power supply is quite good. So I would recommend getting this particular power supply from Circle. Recommended, add it to the cart. Now coming to the case where we'll put all our components in. So since we are spending, so obviously we have spent most of our budget in getting the components that matter the most. So these components were CPU, your motherboard, your RAM, your storage and your graphics card, and obviously your power supply. So we have spent most of our budget there, so we have to cut a few corners in choosing some of these peripherals and other items. So getting a PC case is a totally personal choice. So in that case, what we can do is we can choose the case which is giving us the maximum value for the price it is being offered at. This is a case from Aerocool. This is a decent enough case, mid ATX, so it will give you good amount of room for installing all your components as well as for future upgrades. This is a RGB strip in the front, so anybody who is looking for RGB goodness, here it is. And also it comes with a few pre-installed fans, so you can save some money there as well, and it's really cheap. It is only for 2700 rupees. Recommended, add it to the cart. Now coming on to the monitor. So since we are building our gaming PC, I would recommend getting a monitor that gives you really nice response time. So response time, as I had also explained in one of my previous videos, is the time that it takes for you to physically move your mouse and that cursor to move on the screen, right? So there is a time gap between that. So this particular monitor from Acer, this is a 75 Hertz monitor. So the maximum refresh rate of this monitor is 75 Hertz. This is AMD FreeSync compatible. The biggest point why I'm recommending this particular monitor is because of its response time. So this particular monitor is 27 inches. So this gives us a good amount of real estate. This is a 1080p monitor, which is fine for our needs. And this has only 1 millisecond response time. So this would help you in any kind of competitive gaming. Say for example, if you're doing a lot of Counter-Strike, Overwatch and stuff like that, where you need to be really quick in your responses. So you want lightning fast response. You want, as soon as your mouse moves, your cursor also moves so that you are able to kill your opponent, right? Or rather not get killed. So recommended, add it to the cart. So finally coming down to the peripherals, we want at least a mouse and a keyboard to play our games. This is from Ant Esports. This is a keyboard and a mouse combo. Looks nice. This has got some RGB lights on it. Good enough combination of keyboard and mouse for 1600 rupees. Looks nice as well. Looks gamery. So aesthetics are also covered. So recommend it. Add it to the cart. So now since we have added all the components that we actually wanted in our gaming PC, let's quickly check what is our final shopping cart value. So let's look at the total that we are getting here. So our total for now stands at 1,01,037 rupees. This is very marginally over our budget, but that is fine. Say for example, if you try to look at each of these components online, maybe you are going to get a better deal than what I'm getting right now. So that is where you can save some amount of money. So hopefully this video will help you guys, those who are looking to build either a gaming PC or a good overall PC for this budget of 1 lakh rupees. Do let me know if you have any questions or queries regarding any components. Thank you. Have a great day.